problem of degeneration of spine discs is of great importance. This is a very serious medical and social problem. About 85% of the adult population suffer of spine diseases. Most of the people take medicines and undergo conservative procedures. Many patients require surgery. Such surgery is very traumatic, expensive, and often accompanies with complications and relapses. The human spine is composed of vertebrae and intervertebral discs. You see also the nerve roots. A normal intervertebral disc consists of dense annulus fibrosus and soft, flexible, and adaptable nucleus pulposus. The discs provide shock absorption to the spine. The degeneration or traumatic destruction of the spine discs usually begins with a degradation of the annulus fibrosus and nucleus pulposus. If the annulus fibrosus tears, the nucleus pulposus goes out, and a rising hernia may push the nerve root and provoke pain. This disease accompanies with instability of spine and leads to permanent pain under motion of the diseased spine. To fix such spine instability, surgeons used artificial constructions and screws. The whole arrangement looks like this. The surgery is very expensive. It helps, but does not make patients completely healthy, since the reason of the disease, the defect of annulus fibrosus, still exists. The conceptually novel solution of the problem has been discovered by Emil Sobol. The team of Russian physicists and medical doctors has pioneered laser reconstruction of spine discs. This new approach received the Maiman Award for the application of laser in biology and medicine and the first national award for best doctors of Russia and for the non-medical specialists for the outstanding impact on medicine. The main idea of the new approach is to activate the regeneration processes in cartilage using optothermomechanical effect induced by non-destructive laser irradiation. The activation of biological cells is caused by the precisely controllable laser effect on mechanical stress distribution and cartilage structure. Laser radiation is introduced into a spine disc through a needle. Specific laser regimes are applied to promote tissue regeneration, and after 2-3 months, the new growing cartilage replaces the damaged areas. As a result, the spine is becoming stable without any mechanical fixation. The spine keeps the motion ability, and the patient is returning to normal life. This new technique, laser reconstruction of discs, was first tested on animals. Here you see the spine disc of a rabbit with artificially damaged nucleolus pulposus. The picture shows the rabbit discs in 40 days after laser treatment. You see a new white tissue which is growing and filling the damaged zone. Stable and controlled effect of laser regeneration of cartilage allowed us to begin clinical trials. The patient suffers from pain in the neck, forearm, headache, and dizziness for many years. In the last months, these symptoms progressed and the patient lost working ability. Pre-operation examination has shown deformation and instability of spine discs. Magnetic resonance imaging shows a protrusion and damage of the discs C4, C7. Axial sections show the myelopathic features. The procedure is performed under local anesthesia. Administration of the needle is controlled using X-ray. An optical fiber is delivered into the disc through the needle. Laser irradiation of the damaged area takes a few minutes. The patient feels no pain at all. Then the next damaged disc is punctured and irradiated. Three zones of irradiation are shown here. The last zone is to be treated. The procedure is nearly finished. How are you? I'm okay. Any unpleasant sensations? No. Headache? No pain at all. Well, very good. The small scratch from the needle will disappear very soon. How are you? I'm okay. Great. Now you will sit up. Do you feel giddy? No. Do you feel any pain or discomfort? No pain, no unpleasant feelings. Well, you can get up, and if all will be okay, tonight or tomorrow morning, you will go home. The patient got serious trauma of the back and suffered from hard pain in the loin, a numbing sensation, and weakness of the right leg for a few months. Conservative treatment does not help. Magnetic resonance imaging shows a large hernia of the disc L4-L5 with a compression of the nerve roots on the right. We will try to help this patient. The plan of the surgery is as follows. The hernia will be removed first. Then we will deliver a needle with an optical fiber and apply the laser reconstructive procedure to the nucleolus pulposus as well as to the defected zone of the annulus fibrosus. Laser irradiation will lead to the regeneration of the new cartilage. New growing will fill the defect. That will prevent instability of spine and hernia relapse. In the operating room, general anesthesia is applied. The first step is removal of the hernia. Here the hernia is removed. The next step is laser treatment. Laser irradiation is delivered through an optical fiber introduced into the disc with a needle. The position of the needle is controlled by X-ray. Here you see the vertebra and the needle tip near the annulus fibrosus. First, the second, and the third zones of the laser treatment are seen. The optical fiber is introduced into the needle and laser irradiation begins. When the first zone of the nucleus pulposus is irradiated, the needle is shifted to the next position where the treatment is required. The patient has awakened. How are you feeling? I'm okay, I had a rest. How's your leg? Do you feel pain? No, nothing unpleasant. The operation is over. Two hours passed. How are you now? Excellent. No pain in the leg, but there's something in the loins. Yes, it is normal. Let's see your leg. Wonderful. it will be okay. You can go home tomorrow. Post-operation examination of the patients. The laser reconstruction of the disc was performed 12 months ago. As a result, the pain disappeared totally. The patient is very well. She has returned to work and normal life. I'm well, I'm very well. I have risen, came alive. When I came to you for the first time, I had a cherished dream to lift my granddaughter. That was for me like a cry for the moon. And you have told me that it will be possible after laser treatment. And it happened. I lifted her up and played with her. I'm very happy. I have completely forgotten my pain in the spine. The patient with pain, resulted from hernia and disc instability, has been operated 8 months ago. Laser reconstruction of the disc allows obtaining stable results. No pain during all the time of observation. MRI before surgery shows the hernia. MRI in 8 months after surgery shows new tissue growing in the nucleolus pulposus. The arrow indicates the direction of the needle movement. This result clearly shows the controllable character of the laser procedure. The new tissue is growing only in the areas of laser treatment. 6 months have passed after laser reconstruction of the disc. The patient is much better, returned to sports. There are some unpleasant feelings in the loins, under heavy duty only. But the leg is absolutely well. Discography examination before laser treatment showed the damage of the disc and rupture of the annulus fibrosus. Discography, 6 months after laser procedure, demonstrated that most of the disc cavity is filled with new tissue. Instability of spine has disappeared. The regeneration process is in progress. A year has passed after Sobol-Baskov laser procedure. How are you now? My life has completely changed for the better. Good. Do you have any pain? Dizziness? No, I don't know why that is. It seems that's not my story. Result with 1 year follow-up for the first 90 patients. Laser reconstruction of discs. Most of the patients forgot pain, returned to normal life, returned to amateur sports. Similar results are for a combined treatment, hernia removal with laser reconstruction of discs. Safety of laser procedure is vital for clinical practice. We are working at the moment on different versions of feedback control systems which must provide precise laser settings. These systems are based on the monitoring of optical, thermal, mechanical, and acoustic properties of cartilage in the course of laser irradiation. One such feedback control system, using an optoacoustic effect, will allow us the remote monitoring of the temperature of irradiated nucleus pulposus without any additional tool introduced inside the disc. The wavelength of laser radiation is crucial for optimization of the LRD technology. We found that erbium glass fiber laser with 1.56 micrometers in wavelength, produced by the Russian company IRE Polus, demonstrated itself extremely well during long-term laboratory investigations and clinical trials. Our studies of the mechanism of laser reconstruction of the discs have shown that thermomechanical effects in laser irradiated cartilage play an extremely important role. Here you see the formation of microbubbles in the nucleus pulposus of the rabbit spine during laser irradiation. These small bubbles provide the mechanical effect of the cartilaginous cells. The structure of laser irradiated cartilage was studied with atomic force microscope, and formation of micropores in the matrix of cartilage was revealed. These laser-induced micropores are crucial for effective reconstruction of a disc. To reveal the peculiarities of formation of temperature fields inside the disc, treated with modulated laser radiation, high spatial and temporal resolution thermal vision system was applied. The temporal modulation of the laser beam with specific modulation frequency allows enhancing the opto-thermomechanical effects. Here you see the results of temperature measurements. They prove that laser effect is local and controllable. The amplitude of the temperature oscillations diminishes with the distance from the laser spot, and there is no heating at all at the spinal channel. As a result of comprehensive studies during more than 10 years, the specific regimes and parameters of laser irradiation of disc were established, which allowed to activate the reconstruction of the disc, and what is of great importance, simultaneously prevents any undesirable side effects. Important peculiarity of the Sobol-Boskov technique for laser reconstruction of the spine discs is controllable effect of the laser radiation. Locality and modulation of laser radiation allows precise control of the position and dimension of the new growing tissue. What is more, turning laser setting and irradiation topography, we open potential prospect to activate the growth of various types of tissues: fibrous cartilage, hyaline cartilage, or even bony tissue. This microphotograph, obtained using an atomic force microscope, demonstrates laser-induced growth of the collagen fibers of the new bony tissue at the boundary between annulus fibrosus and vertebra of a rabbit spine. We continue research directed to optimize and broaden the technology. At the moment, Sobol-Boskov technique allows treating a lot of patients with degenerative diseases of spine discs. Laser reconstruction of spine discs has a great potential. It already helps and will help in the future a large category of patients to whom the conventional surgery is not applicable, and also to whom conservative medical treatment is useless. Furthermore, LRD opens new prospects for the treatment of scoliosis, serious diseases of joints, arthritis, for many diseases of cartilage. To all appearance, our new findings will allow us to treat the bone diseases in spine and in other parts of the human body. We hope that laser reconstruction of tissues will bring health and happiness to a great many people. This patient returned back to work and normal life in 2 weeks after surgery, combined with laser reconstruction procedure.